perfectly covered up, nice clean white dice. Now all you gotta do is line it up. And obviously what you see too, I don't know if you can come and see close to here, but I'm not worried about how this is gonna be. I'm gonna end up going through in detail, pinstripe, pulling white highlights with the brush to make this thing really pop out. So we're still in the rough stages. So there we go. Throw a piece of masking paper over that. Let's move on to some dice. Okay, right now we're at the step. I've cut out some oval circles from vinyl with the plotter, and I've set all my numbers, or my circles on to make the numbers. And just taking it and set it on. And since my base is already white, the circles will actually stay white and give us the number. We'll just spray red over the top of that. So now we have all those set on. Pretty good. I'm going to go in with some Euro Red. This is mixed 1-to-1. This is a Floris Seal bottle. Dave's gone over it before in another video, splitting it halfway in the bottle, half paint, half reducer. That gives you 1-to-1. Very easy to mix paint using that system when you're airbrushing. So I put that aside. Have a bottle of RU311 on the side as well. So this is 1-to-1. I'm going to add 20%. Easy as that. Shake up. The reason why I did this, because it makes the red base coat more transparent. It's gonna show through and I can actually layer on the red instead of it going a solid red off the first pass. So, as you can see, it's laying on really softly. And now you can see the dots kind of showing up. There's one. And I'm just kind of roughing it in now. We'll come back in later and put some tape on it to actually give us our defined edges. But for now, I'm starting on the sides and working my way up to the top. Much better. So we'll let that dry. We're gonna come back in with some tape and we'll be able to actually give our three-dimensional sides to our dice. One step closer. Okay, we went over and already taped off our top part of the dice. I'll actually pull this back and show it to you. I used 1/8-inch fine line blue tape, make sure it doesn't bleed. Then I went over a 3/4-inch and just cut out the top part of the dice. I'm gonna use the 3/4-inch as well to make our angles. So connect that corner to that corner, gives us a side of the dice. I'm doing this dice first, because this is in back of it, this one's in front. So you can see I put an extra piece of tape there. We'll be able to shadow that and push that off without even doing anything. The actual red, I'm just gonna take black, throw about 3 or 4 drops into it. Give it a shake. All right, I made brown. And a little bit more, maybe 5. And automatically, without changing colors, I've already created a shadow color. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna spray it this way, from the tape that way. I've also taken it and pulled it back so that the overspray would kick out just in case we don't get that line there. Same thing with this side. Pull it up a little bit. Give yourself a little extra protection for overspray. Go in and darken one side in, keeping it more towards the bottom. We'll also do it towards the back. So almost instantly, we got our sides of the dice. And then we'll just go back in, same thing on this side. Hit it towards the bottom. I go back and shadow it towards the backside to give the perspective, make the corner of it pop out a little bit more. As you can see as well, I'm blowing from this part of the paper and blowing up, so that way it's darker and it fades off to light. And like that, three-sided dice. So once we do that, we're gonna go back through and we'll pull this tape off and do the same thing for the other side. So onto the second die, we'll do the same exact thing. This angle's tweaked a little bit more, so a little bit more darker towards the back. See, automatically it's already pushed back. And it looks like this is actually behind our front piece of dice. It's a pair of dice. Uh-huh. All right, here we go. Finish that, pull off your blue tape. And there we have two dice. You can see when I'm pulling this vinyl off, I'm just kind of pulling a corner and then I roll it with my finger. The sticky backside of it's going to stick to your finger and be able to roll off without getting too much of a residue of glue. See, just like that. So continue pulling these off, go through and shadow these in a little bit more, and we'll be able to unveil it. All right, we got our colors done, we got our shading done. What I did is I add a little bit more black to this, and I went from our medium tone to now our dark shadow color, which is almost a dark brown. And I'm gonna go through and shadow in the dice holes, the numbers, kind of with a half tone. We wanna make sure the bottom part of it is the highlight because they're actually concaved. Bottom part's gonna be highlighted, top's gonna be shadowed. So I'm just gonna freehand it. Letting the overspray carry down, it'll actually fade it out and make it look like it's indented. And we'll do that for all the holes. And then when you get to the top, it's concave, so we're gonna actually shadow bottom side, let the hot side come out towards the top. So it looks like it's actually inset. And just kind of go through, and we will take a freehand shield just to clean it up a little bit, make it a little bit darker. Look how that popped it out. Boom, cool. So we'll finish out the rest of these dice with the shadows, and we'll be able to pull this thing off and see what it looks like. Okay, last step, I'm going in with a freehand shield and I'm just kind of making sure my edges and all my corners are lined up and darkened enough before I actually pull everything off, but we're at the stage of seeing what it looks like. So, here we go. Let's start with this. Look at that. Bam! Really pops out.